Throughout Turkey, the ezan, or call to prayer, is chanted 5 times a day in Arabic. God is most great. There is but one God. Muhammad is the prophet of God.
Ashhadu anna Muhammad ar-Rasulullah.
The ritual washing of feet and hands before entering the mosque dates from the beginning of the Muslim religion. The Quran is of supreme importance to the Muslim, for he believes that it contains God's words transmitted through Muhammad's lips. The structure of Islam rests upon this sacred book, which was left to posterity by the Prophet Muhammad in 632 AD. These are dervishes, the mystics of the Islamic religion. The Quran is full of poetic expressions. God is the light of the heavens and earth. Light upon light, God guides to his light who he will. Rich in folk music, are descended from Muslim Turkish tribes who entered the land from Central Asia in 1071 and by 1453 had captured the eastern capital of Christianity, Constantinople. Constantinople, known today as Istanbul, is flanked by the Bosphorus Sea. Men of the sea build their boats to designs which have been handed down over the centuries. These are no welded ships, but assembled rib by rib by the hands of craftsmen. Modern Turkey lies like a bridge between two continents, the beautiful European part contrasting harshly with the central Anatolian plateau in Asia. Here, village communities have been established wherever nature has afforded protection from the cruel wind of the arid Anatolian plains. True to the Islamic sense of religious unity, the village communities live as families, sharing the joys and sorrows of everyday life. It's this feeling of togetherness over the years that has motivated the tradition of village folk dancing. The çepikli is a traditional community dance found all over Anatolia. It's performed during weddings and other social occasions, and one feature of it is the periodic hand clapping. Turkey has a vast repertoire of folk dances, but invariably the zurna, a double reed instrument, provides the melody while the drum beats the rhythm. In contrast to the hardships of life on the Anatolian plains, the coastal regions bordering the Black Sea and the Mediterranean have the most fertile agricultural land in the country. The Turkish Empire was established in Konya in the 11th century, and by the 13th century, a poet and mystic called Celaleddin Rumi had made Konya the most culturally famous city in West Asia. His poetry is filled with spiritual experience expressed in simple terms. Higher than the highest, O beautiful God, no one can conceive what you are like. We explore the sky to drag you down to earth, while you stay housed in believing souls. This mosque was the center for Rumi's teaching in mysticism. Here sleep the bodies of his disciples, mystics who shared his belief in calling God through song and dance. Rumi also lies buried nearby in a special tomb. On his deathbed, he addressed his son with these humble words. Go rest your head on the pillow and leave me alone. Leave this poor, burnt-up, night-roaming, miserable man. Spanning the hours between dusk and dawn, we have struggled in vain to float on waves of joy. If you wish, come then and forgive, or go away and torture me. Rumi rebelled against orthodox Islamic beliefs by dictating songs to replace formal prayers. He left behind the Matnawi, six books which have been used ever since by the Mevlevi Dervishes as the scriptures of the order. Come here again and again, whoever you happen to be. Our seat holds no despair, even if you have violated your vows 100 times. Come now. All religions have given rise to characteristic forms of art, and in Turkey, the simple prayer mat evolved into carpets of great artistic value, woven to cover the cold stone floors of the mosques. This instrument is called balama, the Turkish folk equivalent of the lute. Although made upon primitive looms, these carpets often reflect the beauty of color and design of those made during the nomadic days of the Turks. The sheep from which the wool comes somehow thrive on the desolate Anatolian plains and have done so for untold years. The simple music of the shepherd is no less ancient. We are the flute, God. Our music is yours. We are the mountain echoing you. Like pawns on a chessboard, you have formed us in file to move us to defeat or victory. Lions glare high on streaming flags as your wind, invisible, sweeps us through the earth. As a boy, Rumi left his home in Balkh in Afghanistan to accompany his parents on a long and perilous caravan journey which ended in Konya, where he was destined to establish the Mevlevi Order of the Dervishes. And it is here that today the devotees celebrate with the ecstatic dance he created. Here, all men are equal in God's eye, as each pays homage to his fellow man, regardless of age or position. Kings lick the earth with which the fair are made, for God has mingled in the dusty earth a measure of beauty from his choicest cup. It is that, fond lover, not those lips of clay, you are kissing with 100 ecstasies. Sema, or revolving movement, is said to signify the motion of the sun, moon and stars. And through this movement, the dervishes gently attain a state of religious ecstasy. But in order to achieve this, the formal ritual must be followed. For example, the skirts must not flow outwards in a circular pattern, they must take on a triangular shape. Dancers must revolve in an anti-clockwise direction, turning on the left heel while gathering motion with the right foot. The dervishes rotate with widespread arms. The right hand open to the sky in a gesture of receiving, while the left hand faces downward towards the earth, as if giving. Their smooth, steady, floating movement may look simple, but it takes years of practice for a novice to learn how to whirl correctly without colliding or falling over from dizziness.
Thank you.
Our speech and action is the outer voyage. Our inner journey is above the sky. The body roams on its dusty path. The spirit walks like Jesus on the sea. This art of revolving enables the dancer to contemplate, and through contemplation achieve a religious experience where he attains a oneness with God. Mysticism in Islamic folklore is deeply rooted in ancient Turkish history, and in addition to the whirling ceremonies of the Mevlevi dervishes, there are several other sects who attain oneness with God by different approaches. Few Western observers have ever been permitted to witness these sacred ceremonies, and the film camera has never been admitted before. In gatherings like this, one is aware of the total unity of each participating body and mind. As the word Allah is chanted over and over again, the act of breathing is focused on the thought of God. Different stages of this long act of prayer, which lasts 3 hours, a solo voice intones songs of mystical love. Let God lift you to ecstasy, offering nectar. Come and proclaim the oneness of God. For there is no other God but Allah. Singing is the language of the heart. Through voices of men who love the truth, together with those who have faith and honor, I call you, my Lord. A occasionally, physical pain is self-inflicted as a means of demonstrating that the spirit is not a slave of the body. The instrument used consists of a needle-sharp skewer, which carries at its head a symbol of the sun with our solar system around it. Although the skewer has gone right through his tongue, he will suffer no permanent disfigurement, and with the withdrawal of the instrument, the wound heals immediately, and no bleeding follows. While the Orthodox treat God according to their interpretation of the prophet's law, the mystic approaches him with the intensity of a lover. And from the days of Rumi, the dervishes have appealed to God through music, dance, and poetry. And the philosophy of Rumi's life is remembered to this day by followers in his simple words. I was raw, then fired until I burn in love's flame.